This week's phrase of the week is Honga Val Hiadai. It means congratulations.
Barita, everybody. Welcome back to our Reach Assembly and to the penultimate week, the last but one week of school. Lots of exciting things happening this week. Hope you're going to have a lovely week. Okay, so back to our Reach Assembly. One of my favourite assemblies this week because it thinks about all the things that can help us to be happy and healthy learners. So let's just revisit our question from the beginning of this half term. What is happiness? What do you think happiness is, and what have you learnt about happiness to this point? Today I'm going to talk to you about five ways to well-being. The five ways that we can help our well-being in everyday life. So these are them: connect, keep learning, be active, give and take notice. Have a good look at those. Take a screenshot. They're the things you need to remember. So let's talk a little bit more about those. So by being active, we mean being physically active, because this improves our physical fitness and mental well-being by raising our self-esteem, which we talked about quite a lot earlier on in the year, and giving us that real sense of achievement. Exercise, it doesn't matter what it is, it could be walking, hula hooping, dancing, football, or anything else that takes your fancy. It causes a chemical change in our brains, and that can help to change our mood for the better. So really important that we stay active and think about doing activities that make us happy. Taking notice, again, we've done a little bit of this in terms of mindfulness and noticing what's happening around us, and noticing skills in terms of good learning. But paying attention to things around us can help us to feel calm and peaceful. So thinking about what our thoughts are at that moment, how our body is feeling at the moment, perhaps noticing things around you like nature, trees, things like that, just can help you to enjoy life a bit more and understand yourself a bit better and the way you're feeling. As I've just said, sometimes we call this mindfulness, sometimes it's just sitting and being quiet. So keep learning. And that's what we're all about at St. Andrew's, learning for different things and in different ways and for different reasons. And when we adopt an attitude that there's always something to learn, we can increase our well-being. Because learning a skill, it doesn't matter whether it's a really big skill or a small skill, or taking on a new hobby, can boost our self-esteem and make us feel much more confident. Giving our time, giving our skills, giving resources to help others has proven to help us too. Research suggests that acts of giving and kindness can improve our mental well-being by creating positive feelings and a sense of reward. And I know lots of children across the whole of our school have done lots of giving for different reasons over this year. I know that we've had giving to the hospital, NHS, we've had giving to teachers around the school for various different reasons. We've had kindness in the community. And that all of those things give us a feeling of purpose and self-worth, and they help us to connect with other people that we might not normally connect with. And finally, just thinking about that connection, good relationships are really, really important for our well-being. It's really important to connect with others. And we can do that when we eat lunch together or just chat with a friend, switch off the TV to talk or play a game with family, or volunteer to help a younger sibling or another person in school. Because when you do these things, you experience a greater connection with others, which is really, really good for you. So we're just going to watch a little clip now that goes over all the things that I've just talked to you about in terms of the five ways to well-being.
Sometimes life can feel challenging, empty, or stressful. We have so much going on in our heads, it's easy to feel disconnected. Five Ways to Wellbeing are simple things we can all do to help us enjoy life and be kinder to ourselves. Just taking a little time out for yourself and taking notice of the simple things can make a huge difference, helping you feel more relaxed. Connecting with others can be daunting at first, but it's worth it when you meet a friend. Learning something new can help build your confidence and get you involved in something you've always wanted to try. Even small acts of generosity can activate the reward centre of the brain, which reduces our stress levels and even helps us live longer. Simply moving your body around has so many benefits. When you're active, your body releases chemicals in your brain which make you happy. They also help you concentrate, feel and look better, and sleep better, which is pretty great.
So remember, life is definitely better with friends. Okay, just thinking about friendship at the moment, can you think of what ingredients would make a good friend? What do you think you need to be a good friend? And what do you think others that are good friends have that make them good friends for you? Here are just some of the things that you would need to be a good friend. So you definitely need loyalty. You need listening, kindness, fun, honesty, encouragement, patience, respect and trust, and forgiveness. You might want to pause here and just talk about some of those things on the ingredients there and just have a chat within your class about those words and whether you've come up with similar words or words that mean the same thing and why those words might be important in your friendships. Let's take a moment to reflect. How can you be a better friend? Can you be a better friend? If so, what can you do? This week, think about your friends, think about how you're treating them, think about what makes them good friends, and think about being a better friend each day. That's it from me this week. Let's just say our school prayer together. Gweddion. Diolch I ti am ei byd, diolch am ein ffrindiau I gyd. Amen. Thank you very much for listening and for joining in with my assembly today. I look forward to seeing you all this week. Dabwch I.
being me.